But first, as you and I only know too well, what happens in schools matters, because after our homes, schools are the places that most shape us, and good schools are needed if young Australians are going to succeed in an ever more demanding and complex world. As we know, that objective on all indicators, well, our schools are falling behind. Despite ever increasing spending on schools, some $57 billion across primary and secondary schools last year alone. When it comes to ability in maths, for instance, our children are now 3 years behind their peers in Singapore. So while the new maths curriculum is certainly needed, it has to be one that's better, not worse. More than 200 concerned citizens, mostly professors and teachers of mathematics, have now signed an open letter to the Australian Curriculum Assessment and Reporting Authority. That's the body called ACARA, asking that the new draft maths curriculum be scrapped and that the whole process is started again from scratch. The existing curriculum, they say, desperately requires reform because it is repetitious, disconnected, unambitious, and lacking in critical elements. But far from improving things, the 200 plus signatories, all experts in maths, they say they are profoundly concerned with the current draft and that many of the proposed changes worry them. One of them, Melbourne University maths professor Tony Goodman, says that the new draft has, quote, a tendency to jump on certain bandwagons. We can say that again. The official blurb for the new curriculum says coyly that new content elaborations have been written which illustrate how the cross-curriculum priority of Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander histories and cultures can support the teaching and learning of mathematics. Couldn't make that up. That's his quote. Well, here's what that actually means in practice. Math students are to investigate, quote, fractions, decimals, and percentage forms in the patterns used in the weaving designs of Aboriginal people. Are you kidding me? How about fractions without indoctrination? How about straight numbers without the moral loading? The new draft curriculum goes on. And to investigate, it says, quote, the area of Aboriginal people's traditional grain belt compared with Australia's current grain belt. And quote, the nutritional value of grains traditionally cultivated by Aboriginal people in proportion to grains currently cultivated by Australia's farmers. Now, an Indigenous grain belt, when experts still maintain the hunter-gatherer lifestyle is the experience of Australia's Aboriginal people, not the dark emu farming myth. Why is that happening? This is supposed to be maths, yet it's propagating the cultural revisionism that expert anthropologists and archaeologists are rejecting. Students are asked to investigate, so says the draft curriculum, again I quote, potential cultural bias relating to Aboriginal peoples by critically analysing sampling techniques in statistical reports. Now, pretty obviously, this is just further evidence that the process of shaping the Australian school curriculum has been hijacked by activists. History, English, other subjects, and now maths. Maths, a subject I would have thought at least was about as binary as you could get. I mean, a sum. It's either right or it's wrong. Instead, now it's full of woke warrior nonsense. But what could we expect when the curriculum's body, the Advisory Aboriginal Board, reportedly now includes activists who believe that our country is born of racism? As a distinguished Indigenous leader, now Senate candidate Jacinta Price, has said, education is no longer education, but ongoing indoctrination. Now, plainly, grandparents, parents watching the show, concerned Australians, this has got to stop. And education ministers, as the only elected and accountable people in this whole system, not these advisory boards, not ACARA, not the public servants, it's only the MPs we can hire and fire, they have a duty to stop this. As the Federal Education Minister Alan Tudge has pointed out, because this new draft curriculum has to be approved by consensus, any one of the state or indeed himself, the federal education ministers, could veto it. So here's the big question. one of them has the guts and courage, common sense, to do the vetoing. I tell you what, Alan Tudge, we are all relying on you to lead the charge.